other end, it's Alex Stalock for the Blackhawks here on home ice in the final week of the regular season. And off we go. You will see the starting lineups at the top of your screen. They're brought to you by Taco Bell. As Gustafson plays it in the trapezoid, trying to drop it off for Caitlin Addison. Draws back in for Minnesota today in the fourth line for the Wild. Maneuvers it out to center.
Funky bounces coming off of the boards, but you see sort of lackadaisical getting back in position. He does get there in time, but interesting.
He's out there centering this line now in the O-zone for the Wild. Work back toward the line. Faber put a shot on net, and Alex Stalock kicks out the leg on Johansson.
Chicago's had some chances, but take a look here. There's a good play, and then Tyler Johnson right there just sort of flies by. He's got to put the brakes on, got to put some pressure, and from that...
A lot of moving parts. That's what Luke Richardson said to us this morning. It feels like it's always changing. Here's Gaudreau off the giveaway, and a backhand bid denied by Stalock.
So many missed passes for the Minnesota Wild. Just in their skates, misfiring.
Shots are 6-4 in favor of Chicago. Johansson, extra pass, shot, Stalock the save, rebound, poked home, and Minnesota strikes first, and who else but Matt Boldy.
What beautiful passing, though. A beautiful odd man rush on this side. They draw the defense over, and then what a good pass over to Matt Boldy. What's really impressive here is how Matt Boldy stays with it. Jumps up, doesn't score on the initial shot, drives the net, and is able to tuck it in behind.
The play from Johansson, for me, is the key.
Now Kara moves it. Porkachuk looking to center for Anderson. Angling a drive, couldn't get it through the stick of Addison. Good Chicago stick from Anderson. Keeps it in the zone. Kachuk wheeling around on a wraparound feed for Anderson. Trying to poke at it in front of Gustafson. They score! Oh, a workmanlike goal for the Blackhawks off the efforts of Joey Anderson has tied this game at one.
Over the weekend, he tries to use the 7-iron to chip this one out. It doesn't go anywhere.
That's the play right there, though.
Right back around the net. And then it caroms out the ricochet, and Gustafson's already down early, but sloppy play all around, unusual, uncharacteristic. In the production of Boldy, coinciding with the arrival of Marcus Johansson.
Boldy with his 31st goal of the season. Middleton emerging out of his own end. And flipped wide by Rossi, but knocked down by Athanasiou, who feeds Buddy Robinson. Walking in and a save made. Rebound score! Rebound squirted out toward Anders Bjork. Off the work from Robinson and Athanasiou. And the Blackhawks lead here in Chicago.
Well, it's the old pass off the pads, right? Give yourself a second opportunity. This is a nice little pass to space, and then this is just the old P.O.P. Go off the pad, give yourself and your teammate another crack at it, and it pays off just barely.
Through center, Wyatt Kaiser went tumbling. Marcus Johansson gets to his skates. Connor Murphy gets bumped. Shoveled across by Taves, and Johnson on a backhand. Couldn't get all of it. Chicago controlling possession here the first 6 minutes in this second period.
Yeah, they seem a lot more together, the way that they're playing.
Backhander saved by Gustafson on Caleb Jones.
You know, these guys, it's a lot of different guys in the lineup, different lineups, and coming in, getting a good opportunity. Gustafson tracks that puck. I talked a little bit in the first period about how he's having trouble finding the puck. He's having trouble tracking it. Even that's how they scored.
There's a stretch pass gets broken up by the Blackhawks, and now up ahead, caught in a change, walking in, Johnson denied! Gustafson makes the stop with the left pad on Reese Johnson.
Stops the puck, and you know what, he's thinking about this pass, and he's still out of this. If he misses that pass back, though, that's a goal again, so good on him. Recognize that they're in a change, and Dom, it goes back to exactly what you're talking about, the long change here in the second period. Certainly a good addition for this team, and when asked afterwards how he felt after being out for so long, he said, I'm a little rusty in the brain. Looked pretty good to me, though.
Kaiser stick handling in, and Gustafson the save on Wyatt Kaiser's backhand bid.
You know, Luke Richardson talked to us this morning about his feet on display here. Quick little steps, gets through the seam and tries to shovel a backhand. Again, similar to Faber, offensive is a work in progress, but...
Stalock in the trapezoid, guides it on for Murphy. Up ahead on a quick hitter that reaches Anderson. Anderson across, Kachuk off the post! Trying to make it a two-goal Chicago lead.
On the change from the Wild that creates this chance. You're not going to get a look at it, but Faber was on the bench right beside me and did not jump on because he wasn't sure if he would be too many men or not. By the time he jumped on... It is a thing. It's been a thing.
I know it's a thing, but calling it pass off the pads, I get it. P.O.P.
But Steele recovers and chips it back toward the point. Pass picked off, and Dickinson speeds ahead. Dickinson denied by Gustafson. Coming up with a huge save to prevent a shorting. Moldy got a piece after the CU recovers. Gains the line on the entry, banks it around for Jonathan Toews. He gets undercut. Back to Jones. On a pass for Athanasiou. Out in front, they score! Jonathan Toews makes it a two-goal Chicago lead.
He was the one with the entry. He rings this puck around. Jonathan Toews gets it up to the point. Now right here, instead of shooting this puck right away, he waits, gets it into the middle of the ice, and then they get two kicks at the can again. And it's going to be Jonathan Toews, the captain, in what could be one of his final games.
Discussion with the officials. Minnesota gained possession and control of the puck prior to the puck entering the net. There's no goal. Minnesota, two-minute liner, hold it.
So a Chicago power play for about 30 seconds as Stalock drops it off for Athanasiou with a man advantage for the Blackhawks, leading by a goal with about six to play. Off the turnover, Johansson fires and scores! To tie the game with a shorty here in the third.
Lack of urgency with the puck and sitting back a little bit, bad giveaway in the neutral zone. You gotta manage the puck, you gotta protect it, and Johansson jumps on it. What a finish. You've been talking about him all night, Dom. Look at that shot.
Well, we've been talking a lot about it.
While they have clinched the playoff spot tonight, they are without five regulars. And here's Johansson again. He does feed Boldy. Oh. Johansson scores again!
Wow.
And the Wild lead just like that. Wow!
From the very beginning of the game, watch this entry, the drop, and then the fake shot, this time from Boldy back to Johansson. Earlier it was the fake shot from Johansson to Boldy, now...
Along the half wall, centering towards Dickinson. Athanasiou out in front looking for Toews, who was parked there. And now Nyquist on it for the Wild, and Nyquist scores! To cap a Minnesota comeback on the road.
Back to the first period, Minnesota was a little bit running around in their D zone, trying to figure out how to play the extra guy, and there's a good bounce, Gus Nyquist.
Yeah, trust in, you know, hey, let's see what you can do, kid.
Yeah.
Wyatt Kaiser behind the net, Gustafson kicked it out. Behind the net, Faber fights for it, and how about the Wild in the third to come back, shorthanded and beat Chicago.